Very short update today, guys, because the price basically stays in the same level after the drop. Nothing really changed, and I will tell a couple words about the TA a little later. But just let's look at the news. Also, not so many like meaningful or impactful news. One from the Bitcoin from the Coinbase executive, which is predicting that Bitcoin will turn a big corner this year, basically saying that a lot of developments is made and we are making progress on the regulation, in the regulation area, especially in Europe. So yeah, just some positive opinion. But the thing is that it was published on Forbes, which is quite promising. This I would like to mention guy Jake Chervinsky, which is the lawyer, and he was has a huge thread in Twitter, and actually I think in even the an article on Medium. So he covered the thing about the process of ETF acceptance by SEC, and with the light of the government shutting down, is shut down. So he's saying that okay, there is a chance that ETF would be automatically accepted, because if the SEC would be unable to make a decision during this period of time until 27th of February, when it is the deadline for the decision, then according to the law, then this ETF will be auto accepted. So in fact, this is possible, but very unlikely, he said. He made his point saying that although SEC has the lack of the staff now, right now, and just like a few, maybe 10% of them are working, still there will be enough people to just write a short note saying that the ETF is denied, not accepted. Declined. And the thing is, if there will be not, they will not continue like on the full scale their work, it's really likely to happen. Another thing is that he said that maybe there is a chance that ETF will be approved, but it requires the fact that it was like it was already approved before the government shut down, so the decision was already made, so they will need just to publish it. And moreover, if even according to this law the ETF will be approved with if this SEC will not make a decision, not be able to make a decision within this term, then still it would be easy to cancel out eventually, like say no, it's not good, let's delist ETF and everything. So also he mentioned that it doesn't relate to BACT, because CFTC has a different like that doesn't have a deadline for their decision, so this is only for SEC and ETF from VanEck Solid X. Okay, that's the point. So a little bit pessimistic standpoint, but he has his arguments, and I think it's really likely that indeed we will not have this ETF. So let's see. We have not so much time to wait. So speaking about the price, as I said, not so many things changed, but I would like to refer to these total capitalization of the crypto market chart. And if we'll switch to the weekly chart, we will see that we are now again just above the 200 week moving average. And yesterday this drop happened when we didn't go below this line actually, and we didn't even touch it actually. And the thing is, as soon as we are above that, we are approaching the top, the resistance of line of this wedge, and that will be resolved like within a week or something, maybe 2 weeks until the end of the month. And we will see how the things will evolve, because the break out of from this triangle is really a strong signal, and break down from the 200 weeks moving average is also a very strong signal. So we either will make a new low or something like that, or we will change the trend to make it bullish, or at least make an attempt to make it bullish. So I would pay close attention to that. The rest is pretty silent, like the number of shorts and longs are pretty much the same, doesn't change much with even with this drops, previous drop of Bitcoin. Interesting thing about the fractals, which I published some time ago, like it was one, two fractals over here, and then those green areas, I even didn't even mention them, but now I had to do this. So after this huge pink oval, there was a sideways price action, and then we had similar price action as what was before with a smaller scale, and then again some sideways price action, and then just recently, because of the high rise and fall, we had very similar picture of what we had here. So in principle, with the if the fractals are valid to use as some kind of the indicator, then such a change of the scale would imply that actually the trend was changed, and this was the bearish trend, and now we're sort of flattening out, and maybe we're about to go upwards. So we'll see how the things will evolve. As you see, there are, as usual, there are mixed signals, especially on such an uncertain period of time. But the rest of the things are basically the same as I stated yesterday. So if you want, just refer to my yesterday's update in the link in the corner of your screen. So that is it for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and see you tomorrow in the next update. Goodbye.